Hello, welcome back. This is module 6. And in this one, I'm going to return to the area of queries. Remember, we did some queries from text. We did the queries from SQL, combining with text. And then we did some docs. And now I'm going back to an example using queries. And in this example, let's switch to the Excel screen. And look at this report. And this report is not our target report. It's not that we want to build this report. The fact is that the scenario here is that this is what we got as input. This is the data we have. And why is that? This is kind of typical in many organizations. In some cases, you have access to a very nice data warehouse, and you're a business analyst, and you get access to the data warehouse, and you know the data warehouse, and everything is fine. In other cases, you don't have access to the data warehouse, but you still have access to some tool that will export the data you need into text files. And you use these text files, maybe multiple of them, you combine them, we saw how to create relationships, have multiple tables, great. But in other cases, maybe you don't even have that. The only thing you have is a reporting system that creates this report, nice looking, headers, repeating headers. It has data for each month. You see January through December going across the rows. And this is, and you want to create some analysis of your own based on this, but you don't have access to the data behind it. So what we have to do is to use this as our input. Looks pretty difficult when you look at it. And if you think about how to do this in Excel, you are up to some real challenges. And not only is it challenging to make from this data some useful format, a useful shape that you can use to create your own analysis, but also you are thinking about the number of times you will have to repeat the steps of creating from this a useful thing. So if you are a VBA person, you might thinking of writing some complex, sophisticated macro to do this conversion. If you're not, you're just counting your copy-paste operations, how many times you will have to do it and how many errors, and maybe thinking of can you offload this work to someone else and not have to repeat it. So let's see how Excel 2016 in this case, or Power Query as embedded in the previous version, can help you to use this and make it into a useful data to do your analysis. So I can close this because this is it's not the file that I'm going to use. I'm going to actually create an empty file and go here and create myself a new query. The query will be from file, and the file is an Excel file. And the file is called report. I click on it. Actually, the query now reads this data, show me that there is something called sheet one. It reads the data, shows me the preview, which is not very encouraging because it has all kind of things which I know I need to fix before I can use it. But I click on the edit, and I'm hopeful that the query will help me. Again, it tells me that there's a preview cache and it's 6 days old. I can refresh it. It doesn't matter because anyhow, it's the data haven't changed, but I can go ahead and refresh the preview. So now I started to look at this data and identify what do I need to do. I see that there are two rows here in the front that I don't need these rows, so I want to remove them. I go to the transformation, I see that there is one for removing rows. I can remove top rows, bottom rows, here in this case, top rows. So the first top rows, how many top rows do I want to remove? Just two, gone. Now I'm actually at this row now that it's going to be useful to use as the headers for the table that is going to be eventually created from that. So now I can go and click on the transformation called use first row as headers. You see that it kind of promoted the first row and uses it for headers. Now, you see that the, because of the report, the way it was, if you remember the way it was, the category was is in row one, then this column is empty, and then there is the total for this category and so on. So what I can do, first of all, every row that has a value that contains the value, the word total, I want to filter it out because the totals, I don't need them. So text filters does not contain, I want only if the value does not contain the word total. So this will take care of all the totals and they will go away. Actually, I think I, let me just look again at this. I can click on this parameters. Does not show. Oh, okay. I just, let me read. So once I realized that there is a mistake here, that a lot of rows disappeared on me. And so what I can do is actually I can delete this last step and get back to where I was. So in the, we saw before that we can go back, insert new rows in the steps, and I can also delete. This is like undoing, but undoing here is much simpler. It's just deleting the operation that you don't want. So let's do it in a different sequence. So first I want to actually fill the values for the categories on all these empty rows so that the value for mix will be filled down on all the empty rows below it. So there is a transformation that's called filled. And I will say, select a column. On this column, I want to do a fill down. So now you see that I have the mix spread until the total, and then I have the, in the same way, I have all the others in the filled down, but I still have the totals, the rows that has the totals. So now I want to apply the does not contain. So I want to, I don't want the rows that has the word total in them. Okay, done. And you see that this is an iterative process. You apply something, you see the result. Sometimes you may need to go back and redo it in a different way. There's no clear answer. It's a complex kind of input and you gradually clean it until it gets to the shape that you needed. Another thing is that there were headers, repeating headers. So the first row of headers I've used as headers for my report, but the rest of the headers I need to get rid of. So as an example of this header is this row number 9 that has the word category in it. So again, I can say I want to a text filter where everything, I just want the rows that do not contain the word category. So we're gradually getting rid of all the rows we don't need. So now it seems that we got rid of all the rows, but we have a major obstacle here. We have columns for each month from January to December. So 12 columns with values. Actually, there's an extra column here that is empty, so I'm going to remove it. There is a total for the year, which I also don't need. I'm going to remove it. So now I'm left with this, the category, the manufacturer, and the values for this each combination of category and manufacturer for each month. But the fact that I have a column for each month is nice for the report, but it's really not good for me to use to creating pivot tables and analysis. What I need is actually a column that will contain the name of the month and another column that will contain the value. So I need to flatten it. Instead of having multiple columns for each month, I want to each one of these columns to become a row. So let's see how can I do it. So I can select from January to December by shift click, I selected all these columns, and I can apply a transformation that is called unpivot. The unpivot, in one simple click, created for me a two columns. So everything that used to be column now becomes row. So for each combination of category and manufacturer, now we have a row for January, February, March, and so on. And it starts again for the other combination of category and manufacturer. Now I can rename the columns instead of attributes. I can call it month. And I can also rename this one to be sales. And now actually I'm pretty much done. I can go to home, close and load. Let's do an example of loading this into Excel. So I do want a table, let's say, and I don't want it in the model. Let's say I want just a simple table in Excel. It's actually also small. I don't have a problem of getting over a million, not by a long shot, because this is just a few. And here it is. This data, actually the total number is 437 rows, is the end result of the report that we showed before. So if I will open once again the report, we started from here and we got to here, and now from here I can actually create a pivot table. So it's a simple table, it has rows and columns, it's ready to go, it's formatted correctly, and I can use it for my reporting. So to summarize what we did in this module, we didn't have a proper source of data from a database or from a CSV file. We just had a report inside in Excel. Our reporting system gave us a report in Excel, and we started from there using a query, cleaned it, shaped it, and actually created this data set that is useful to do further analysis.